Hey, Earth scientists, Bee here. And I might have made a tiny mistake. In my rock collection, these three were all labeled as different minerals: quartz, calcite, and selenite. But I mean, come on, they're practically identical. I thought there's no way they're all different. So I took them out to take a closer look, and well, you can totally understand how I got them all mixed up, right? Right? Wait a minute. There must be some way Earth scientists figured out that these were three different minerals in the first place. Maybe they looked at them under microscopes or traveled back in time to see how they were formed? Well, to get my rock collection back in order, we'll need to figure out how Earth scientists tell the difference between the thousands of different minerals found on Earth. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain how Earth scientists can use the physical properties of minerals to identify and compare them. Let's get started! Before we start identifying these minerals, let's take a moment to review just what a mineral is. A mineral is a naturally occurring solid with atoms organized in a pattern. Minerals are like the ingredients that make up rocks and crystals. So, to identify a rock or a crystal, scientists need to know what minerals are in it. But how do you think they identify different minerals, especially when they look so similar? Pause the video here and record your predictions in your guided notes. Minerals have lots of different physical characteristics, like their color, luster, crystal form, streak, cleavage and fracture, and hardness. Scientists use these physical characteristics to identify minerals. So, let's take a closer look at what each of these mean. Some characteristics of minerals are pretty straightforward, like their color. Minerals can be every color of the rainbow. We can also describe a mineral by its luster, which is the sheen or appearance of its surface. It might be glassy, dull, metallic, pearlescent, waxy, silky, or even greasy looking. Unfortunately, all my minerals are the same clear color and have the same glassy luster. So let's keep going. As we know, the atoms in minerals are organized into unique patterns. These patterns cause each mineral to form crystals of a certain shape. This shape is called a mineral's crystal form. It looks like two of my mineral's crystal forms are in the shape of a rhombus, but one is hexagonal. That might help us identify it. Let's look at their other characteristics. In some minerals, the way their crystal shape or luster reflects light can change the way their color looks. So, to more accurately identify minerals, scientists often use their streak. A mineral's streak is the color it has when ground into a powder. To test a mineral's streak, we can rub them against a very hard surface called a streak plate. It's the same basic idea as drawing with chalk. A thin layer rubs off onto the surface underneath, which lets us see its color more accurately. Streak can be really helpful for identifying minerals. For example, check out these minerals, hematite and magnetite. They look almost identical, right? Except magnetite has a blackish-gray streak, while, surprise, hematite's streak is bright red. The crystal form and luster of hematite can sometimes make it look black, which makes it much harder to identify by color alone. Checking its streak is the best way to tell the difference between it and magnetite. but all of our mystery minerals have a white streak. So let's check some other properties. All minerals have a property called fracture. Fracture is when a mineral breaks in random places when a force is applied, like if it's hit with a hammer. Some minerals also have cleavage, which is when they break along flat planes because of patterns in their crystal form. For example, a mineral's cleavage might make it break into smooth sheets or into small cubes. So both cleavage and fracture describe how a mineral will break apart. All minerals have fracture, but only some have cleavage. A mineral with cleavage might show fracture if just a tiny piece of it breaks off, but it isn't a big enough piece to break along the cleavage planes. So that means all of my minerals have fracture, but what about cleavage? The first one is cleaving into thin, flat sheets. The second is cleaving into rhombuses. And the third one, it isn't cleaving at all. It must only have fracture. I think we're getting close to identifying them. Let's check out one last property, their hardness. A mineral's hardness is how resistant it is to being scratched. Scientists use a tool called the Mohs hardness scale to rate the hardness of minerals from 1 to 10. The higher a mineral is on this scale, the harder it is to scratch. So for example, a mineral with a hardness of 3 couldn't scratch one with a hardness of 5, but a mineral with a hardness of 7 could. In fact, it could scratch any mineral with a hardness level lower than 7. Wow, one of our mystery minerals is so soft I can scratch it with my fingernail. So, we've gathered a ton of information by checking out each mineral's physical characteristics. But what now? How do you think Earth scientists use all these little details to identify minerals? Pause the video here and record your thinking in your guided notes. Earth scientists use all the characteristics of minerals together to identify them. They compare their observations of a mineral's unique combination of characteristics with identification guides that describe tons of minerals to figure it out. And now, I think we finally have enough info to identify our minerals here too. This soft one that cleaved into flat sheets is selenite. This one that's a bit harder with rhombus-shaped crystal form is calcite. And the last one that's way harder with no cleavage and hexagonal crystals is quartz. Woo! I'm glad to have my rock collection back in order. Let's review what we learned along the way. Now you know that minerals have many different physical characteristics, including their color, luster, crystal forms, streak, cleavage and fracture, and hardness, and that Earth scientists use each mineral's unique combination of these characteristics to identify them. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to try out identifying some minerals on your own. And always remember, in earth science, as in life, you rock. See you next time.